Happy Friday, everybody, in the gardens. And I'm starting a little bit later today, which I think in general on Fridays, we're going to do a live on Fridays, and as we always do. And typically we do them in the mornings, but sometimes we have to do them in the afternoons because sometimes I have my yard guy or my neighbor has their yard guy, and it's so loud, it's literally impossible to go live. So today I had to wait for them to finish. But I want to pop on. I actually did go live this earlier today with Liana of Liana Soap, and actually we will post that in the community. It's posted in the Facebook business page right now, and we were featuring her because this is a collaboration we're doing this month. We have a special gift for you guys, for our members, and it's all about body scrub and how to utilize the herbs that you're growing in your wall or in your containers, and how you dry those or you use them raw and fresh and add that into your body scrub. So you're basically going to have a homemade product using your herbs. Very exciting. I'm really excited about this partnership because I think we're going to be doing a lot of different things throughout the year around beauty products that infuse the herbs that you're growing. She even said you could infuse strawberries. I've been growing some strawberries in my wall because I'm testing them to see how they work in the wall, because I think I'd like to offer it to you guys as well as an option for something to grow in the future. And strawberries are a little different because they're, when you grow them in a container, they're really more ornamental. You don't get a ton of fruit out of that, because really how a strawberry plant grows is it grows by runners, and so it spreads out over the ground. And so not as ideal in a container unless you've got a certain kind of container for it to grow in. But it looks so beautiful in the wall, I will say, or even on a container in your patio, that it's a very beautiful ornamental, just kind of like the edible florals are. So that's something to keep in mind. And if you guys are interested in doing that, definitely send us a DM or post in Facebook or send inquiries at plantedplaces.com and let me know so we can incorporate that feedback into what we're making available for you guys to grow. Okay, so what I want to do is a couple things. I want to do what I normally do, which is to walk around the garden and show you some different things that I notice are happening in the garden, and because they're probably happening with you. And I think that will be helpful. Won't be take too much time today. But I did want to let you know that next week we've got a number of things. On Monday evening, I'm going to go live with Robin, Happy Food Chef, and we're going to talk about summer barbecues, marinades, sauces, what you can be doing with what you're growing this time of year. And we're also going to be featuring next Friday, we're going to be featuring Liana and with Liana Soaps, and we're going to be featuring her. We're going to do a live demo of how you take what's in your box that you're getting next week, how you take that body scrub, take your herbs and infuse the herbs in your body scrub. We'll do a live demo. So if you want to do it along with us, you can, or if you want to watch the replay and do it then, you can as well. But that will be next Friday. So Monday we're going with Robin, and on Friday we're doing the live demo of the body scrub, which is a really cool creation that we're going to do. So next week clearly is our ship week for the month, and we've got this time of year, you've got a lot of new herbs that you could be growing. So we've got a lot of those available. We're going to be doing rosemary. We've got lime mint, which is kind of fun. I've never grown lime mint before. I've never really had lime mint, so I'm kind of excited to make different drinks with that. But we also are doing yerba buena, which is, I'm going to have Robin provide some good nutritional information for that. So you'll see that on our member page when you get the box. But yerba buena is very much like a mint, but it's got some medicinal in there. It's really good. So we added that as well. We've got French tarragon this month. We've got a lot of basil, Thai basil. We've got large leaf basil and just Genovese, just a regular basil. And the reason why we've got so much basil this month is this is really one of the last months that you should be planting basil in your garden, unless you live in an environment where it stays warm for a very long time, like Arizona or Nevada. You can usually plant that a little bit later in the summer as well. But for the Bay Area and in mostly California, Southern California, a little different, obviously, but in Northern California, you know, you really, it's starting to get warm now, and you want to get those in your pots, because basil really needs those warm summer months to kind of, it wants that heat to kind of grow and get established, and it takes a little bit of time for it to get established. Like right now, I'll walk around and show you, my basil is just starting to grow in, and but you know, in a month, it's going to start getting really big, and I'm going to have a lot to harvest. So if you can get multiple basil plants going, a lot of you guys have multiple pots with you, either whether you've got, you know, 17 or 33 on a wall, or maybe you've got like 15, 17 that you're growing in the containers. You've got a lot of pots, and I would dedicate a few of those to basil because it's just so delicious when you start making all of the great recipes that you can make with basil. And of course, Robin will be helping us along the way. She is just going crazy with all the recipes and the demos. So make sure to look in Facebook community, but also check your newsletters because we send them out. We send new ones out every Friday. And so exciting, coming later this month, we are launching, it's been in the works under wraps for a while, we are going to be launching a special member site. It is beautiful, it's so wonderful, it's so helpful, and very soon thereafter is going to be kind of a whole deep training program that we're putting together for you. So all this has been in the works for a while, and I'm so excited because it's all getting ready to launch, and I've been seeing sneak peeks of it, and it's so great. It's going to be so helpful for you guys, so I'm really excited about that. But let me walk around. And let me show you some things going on in the garden. And one of the things I want to say, okay, I just have to show this. This is my wall that I have been harvesting. Let me step back a little bit so you can see it. I have been harvesting this thing, literally making salads. This is a double-sided wall. I have been making salads every day. I even had a bunch of family in town last weekend because of all the graduations going on, and I have been harvesting this one a ton. And one of the things that I love about this time of year, which is so good to show you, is that the lettuces, these are more heat-tolerant lettuces. These lettuces are going crazy. And you can see here, like see this one, this romaine right here, really, really large leaves. I mean, look at there's my hand. It shows you how big these leaves are. And you can see here, here's the stem. I have been harvesting this a lot. And this is what I talk about when we do kind of our harvesting of grazing. So, you know, I take 2-3 leaves off of this. These are really large leaves, so they go a long way. That's probably 2 sandwiches worth. If I'm going to do, which I do a lot of times, I'll grill some Beyond Burgers, and I will take the lettuce leaves for instead of the bread. And these work great. Here's the butterheads that we sent to you guys last month. So this is all maize seedlings that are just growing in, and I'm harvesting them like crazy. The arugulas are great. So look at these very, very tall arugula leaves. This is one with, I've got one seedling in here. I've got another one on the front side. This one gets a little bit more sun. So you can see this is a seedling. It's got 2 seedlings in there in this arugula, but these are very, very large leaf. I've already taken like 4 leaves off already this morning because I made a salad. But so really good. The kales are growing in nicely. So everything is just growing in really nicely. I wanted to show you, this is the edible flower we sent to you guys. For some of you guys got this. This is called the barrage. And this is what it looks like. Look at that. Within 1 month, it's blooming. It's just beautiful. But this is an edible flower, and it's spelled B-O-R-A-G-E. Do you see I've got new growth coming in? There's another bud coming in. That's going to, a shoot that's going to grow up as well. But this is what it looks like when it's in bloom. It's just beautiful. Here's the chamomile. This chamomile is really delicious. That's been growing in. And I water this wall right now pretty much about 5 days a week. We actually had a cooler week this week, so I didn't have to water it every day. But if it's going to be staying in the high 70s, low 80s, I'm going to be watering this every morning. 20, 30 minutes is what I do. My cilantro is very happy. It is starting to bolt. Oh my gosh, look at this. I got 2 broken leaves, kale leaves. I guess I'm going to have to eat those. But I wanted to show you this cilantro because this shows you this is a cilantro that is starting to bolt. Do you see how the leaf structure is a little bit different? It's a little feathery versus this is what the regular leaf structure looks like. Sorry, the sun is. So it's a little different, and you can see its stalk is thicker. So what I want to go is I want to go back down to the bottom, and I want to cut that off. And there's enough seedlings in there. It will still go for a while. But once it all starts getting thicker stalks and just all starts kind of creating more feathery leaves, you know it's pretty much done and time to come out of the wall. This one, you can see in here, I cut, see there's a thicker right there. See, I cut that one. That's where I cut the one that was starting to bolt. But everything else looks to be okay right now. But it's getting towards the end of its life there because I have been harvesting that one a lot. Another thing to be on the lookout for is white, let me walk over here to this one, white butterflies. I have not seen, look at that, I got a bee on the lavender. I have not seen any caterpillar signs yet, but I saw a white moth flying around when I was out here just a few minutes ago. And what that is that's a sign to me that he's probably laying caterpillar eggs, and I need to take a look in a few days for caterpillar signs. So let me look and see if I can show you what a sign of a caterpillar is. Typically, this kale could be an example. Do you see how there's a hole in there? Okay, so caterpillars, that's a sign that there could be a caterpillar. What I want to do is I want to turn this upside, my leaf upside down, and I want to look real closely. Now, these caterpillars, I don't see one right now, but these caterpillars that tend to be around this time of year, they're really tiny, tiny green. They're really hard to see, so you have to look very closely for them, and you just kind of smear them off. You just wipe it off the leaf is what you do. If you do start to have a bad infestation of them, then you want to spray them with Captain Dead Jack's Brew, which is an organic bacterium that does kill the eggs and kills the caterpillars, but you do it at night because you don't want the bees to get into it. So you want to do it at nighttime, okay, before, when the bees are done buzzing around your tree. Okay, trying to think of, I want to talk a little bit about tomatoes. So let me go over. I've got a couple different ones. Let me show you this one. Okay, so here's the tomatoes. You guys, I'm sorry. Let me back up here. First off, let me show you this. I had this cool stand I found. This is where I put my containers. So you can see that. I've got it right next to my wall. And this is where I put my containers. And, you know, you can see what happens is, like, the ones on the top kind of get the morning sun, and then in the afternoon, it kind of, these guys are in the sun the most. So this is why I have my tomato, micro tomato, my pepper, jalapeno pepper, and my basil are right there. They're getting the you know, the heat of the day because they like the heat and they want the sun the longest. And then over there in the corner is my spinach. There's a spinach and there's another spinach. And the spinach, those are kind of getting the afternoon shade and they get the morning sun. So, you know, even with the containers, you want to kind of strategically place things. And I will say a note about the spinach over here on this wall because I had a nice looking one growing in here. Here we go. See the spinach. So this time of year, spinach is normally a very cool season crop, but we were able to find a heat tolerant spinach, and this is what you guys got this last month, and it's doing very well. This position, I kind of testing it to see if it can handle it. This spinach is growing in the sun in the hottest part of the day. This gets afternoon sun, and I'm really testing it, and it's performing well, which is nice to know. My basil. Here's my basil, and I wanted to show you. It was being kind of eaten by something. You can tell that because of some of the leaves were being eaten. Now it's starting to recover. What I did is I took off the leaves. I pinched them off, the ones that were being eaten. So here's an example. I'm going to pinch it right there, and you can see that. See, that was being eaten. Most likely it's a caterpillar or something. I looked and looked for the caterpillar. I did not see it, but I'm noticing the new growth is coming in nice, so I think I might have eradicated it. Very excited. I did it without having to spray Captain Dead Jacks, which is always my goal. So I just want to, I watch these very closely. This one, same thing. See if I can make sure I do this closely for you. So this one, same thing. The new growth is coming in nicely, but you can see down below here it was being eaten. So I'm watching this closely, and I am looking.